Amid the threat of new Omicron subvariants, the Philippine Tourism Department says the implementation of health protocols remains its priority, especially as the country receives more foreign tourists. The agency continues to see an improved number of foreign arrivals since the easing of travel restrictions. Secretary Bernadette Romulo Puyat says over 300,000 foreign tourists have arrived in the country between February 10 and April 25. Romulo Puyat says most of them were from the U.S., Canada, and South Korea.
First, pagdating sa accommodation establishments, mga hotels, mga resorts, kahit na yung mga, kahit mabuhay accommodation, we are very strict na dapat sumusunod sa health and safety guidelines na ginawa ng Department of Tourism together with the Department of Health. At in fact, we had the WTTC Safe Travel Stamp. Ibig sabihin, our standards are world standards. We are very strict. Ang maganda ngayon sa social media, kung nyari may lumalabag dito, agad namin nakikita na chichek. Mm-hmm. If lumabag, we give a show cause order. At kung umulit, pinapasara natin. Mm-hmm. So, yon, we're very strict with regard to mga hotel, mga accommodation establishments. But it's very important to work with the LGUs.
The Philippine Health Department investigates the alleged administration of second COVID booster shots to health workers and the elderly by mistake. Monday's rollout of the fourth vaccine dose was supposed to be limited to immunocompromised individuals. But a hospital in Metro Manila reportedly misinterpreted the guidelines and administered the shots to members of A1 and A2 groups who are not immunocompromised. Philippine regulators earlier approved a second booster shot for the immunocompromised, the elderly, and health workers. But the country's Health Technology Assessment Council is still reviewing evidence on the efficacy of a fourth vaccine dose for senior citizens and medical frontliners. The Okta Research Group echoes calls for a ramped-up COVID booster coverage in the Philippines as it warns of a possible resurgence of infections. Okta fellow Dr. Guido David says the Omicron subvariants that are fueling a spike in cases in other countries may also cause another surge here in the Philippines. He says cases may rise by at least 5,000 a day should the new subvariants reach the country.
We're seeing a possible increase in cases. It could happen sometime. Actually, it could happen anytime. Hindi natin masasabi kung kailan makakapasok yun. Ang dahilan dyan, Yusek, we're seeing a surge or an increase in cases sa South Africa tsaka sa Delhi, India. Mm-hmm. And these are countries na medyo similar yung characteristics sa Philippines. So pag nagkakaroon ng increase in cases dyan, lalo na sila, tapos na sila sa Omicron, pero may panibagong sub-variant, ang concern natin ay pag nakapasok itong panibagong sub-variant dito sa Philippines, magkakaroon na rin ng pagtaas ng cases. As of now, preliminary, we're projecting siguro up to 50 to 100,000 active cases, which means siguro mga 5,000 cases per day. Tatas pa rin po, tumaas tayo 5,000 or even 10,000 cases per day.
Over in China, 7 more Filipinos in Shanghai have tested positive for COVID-19. This raises the total number of confirmed infections among Filipinos in the Chinese financial hub to 17. Of that figure, 14 are still active cases. Amid fears of prolonged lockdown, the Philippine government is being urged to hasten the release of aid to affected Filipinos. Philippine officials in Shanghai appeal for more patience as they iron out some details before distributing the assistance.
As soon as possible. So gustong-gusto talaga na po natin, yung pong possible na yon, pinipilit po natin committed yung panahon na yan. Ano. Meron na, halos ano na po, halos nandoon na po tayo. Yung pong merchant na pag halos nandoon na po, na pag-desisyon na at we're just about to parang iron out the final details. At pag natapos po yan, patatakbuhin na po namin. Yung pong $200 po, ano, tulad po ng, ano, ng practice no, sa Hong Kong at sa iba pang lugar, ang $200 po na ito ay para sa mga kababayan natin na nag-COVID positive.
Shanghai is struggling to defeat China's worst outbreak in 2 years despite weeks of strict measures. It has recorded over 500,000 cases since March 1. Panic buying ensues in the Chinese capital of Beijing after authorities ordered a mass testing in one of its biggest districts. Residents fear they could be in for a lockdown similar to that of Shanghai, which entered a fourth week of bitter isolation. Shanghai residents are still struggling with food supply issues. Officials in Chaoyang District, which is home to nearly 3.5 million people, ordered everyone who live and work there to get tested three times over a week. That's after over a dozen cases were detected in the district Sunday.